The strongest storm of the year anywhere on the planet is zeroing in on the Philippines, and we're talking about Super Typhoon Hagupit.
Tom Sater is here to tell us all about it and why it is so dangerous. And you were just saying during the break there, maybe they could get lucky in Tacloban. Well, lucky is...
Yeah, they're not in the clear.
Yeah. Right.
They're not in the clear, but it's trending a little north of Tacloban, which would put the storm surge, the stronger winds north of them. They're still going to see damage. The problem is we're not sure where landfall's going to be. We've never seen a system like this where we can't really nail it down just yet because we can't find any steering currents.
Is this bigger than Haiyan?
No, but it's pretty close, and it's the strongest since Haiyan. So everybody needs to know that. Evacuations have got to take place, and the problem is it's such a large area of the coastline, about 160 to 200 kilometers. That's a lot of evacuations. And how do you can't just jump on a car and you get down the highway. Let's talk about it, because this is a beast of a storm, and it's going to affect a lot of people. In fact, thousands and thousands are living in fear right now. Can you imagine the agony and the frustration? First of all, you're recouping just 13 months after 7,000 lives were lost, and you've been working all year long to try to get your life back together in your home, and you've got another storm system? Here's the path of Haiyan, down to the south in blue. This is now what we're thinking could be a closer path, which has really jumped quite a bit. This is 160 kilometers to the north. The Joint Typhoon Warning Center's now path has moved on land. Remember, the last couple of days, they've kept it offshore. Notice Manila, that's midday Tuesday. Possibly late next week, it's Vietnam. The system has lost its eye, which means it's undergoing a little rebuilding process. When they lose their eye, they lose a little bit of strength. But that eye's going to come back, and it's going to intensify again. Look at the wind gusts, 325 kilometers per hour. Haiyan made landfall with 380 kph winds. Think about it this way. It's such a large storm, it doesn't matter where the landfall is going to be, because we're going to see a mess in a lot of places. Northern island of Samar is where we're looking at landfall. Again, Joint Typhoon Warning Center brings it on land. But there is a variety of models that are still in total disagreement. From if you look at Beijing or South Korea or Taiwan. In blue is Japan, closer to Tacloban. We have models ourselves here in the CNN World Weather Center that dive it down to the south, so you're not in the clear yet. In white is Pagasa. That is the National Weather Agency for the Philippines. They bring it in about 6 p.m. Saturday evening, and we pretty much agree with that. Joint Typhoon Warning Center Sunday morning around 1 in the morning. Already signal 1 in yellow, signal 2. This is kind of like beware or a watch. We're looking at a strength right now equivalent to a Category 5 hurricane. So again, these are going to become level signals 3 and 4 as the storm gets a little bit closer. Let me show you a history of December storms. Washi was a tropical storm. All right, in 2011, it killed 1,200 people, a tropical storm of flooding. Bopha, the very first super typhoon to ever make landfall in Mindanao in 2012 in December, killed 1,100 and over 8,000 families were left to have find some help. So we're watching Hagupit. So again, as we continue to watch the storm system, the eye will redevelop. It will re-strengthen. We do believe north of Tacloban on Samar Island, but it's going to be Legazpi. It's going to be several landfalls as it makes its way west.
And you were saying,
northwest.
I mean, this is some of the warmest waters in the world, which will fuel the strength of this typhoon.
And we have seen one year after another, the storms are getting stronger.
Because the water's getting warmer.
And it's deeper heat.
Which is climate change.
That's
3 to 4 meters, did you say this?
At least meter. We had 5 meters with Haiyan. So we were dropping down maybe a meter.
Right.
It's amazing. And got to get off the coast.
230 kilometer an hour winds?
Is that what you're saying? Well, gusts right now with about 350.
Wow.
I mean, it's amazing. Wow.